verse 11. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 11, very quickly. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 11. You know, it says, wherefore remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision, by that which is called the circumcision made by hands. Praise the Lord. The Gentiles simply mean you are not Israel. You are not of the natural seed of Israel. So you are a Gentile. These people don't have God. And you are called uncircumcision. The circumcision was also significant of our change of life in Christ, where the old foreskin is taken out that the new might be found. So that old nature is taken out. That, and it is done with the sharp knife. You know, that is the circumcision. So you say, these guys, oh, you uncircumcised Gentiles, you don't have Jesus. He says, we were called. So if you are not of Israeli roots, you are a Gentile. And that place is so unkind to call you a barbarian. You see, without Jesus, you know, he said that at that time, you were without Christ. We were without, I was a Gentile, I was like that. Being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel. Oh, glory be to God. The Lord, when he met with Israel, he made covenants with them. And those covenants were so rich that it formed the commonwealth of Israel. If you are in the commonwealth in physical time, you get benefits. Just from being a member of commonwealth, there are benefits that you get. He said, we were aliens. We could not partake of the blessings of life, of the blessings of victories, of the blessings of happiness, of peace and joy. No, we were cut off from that class. He said, we were aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenant of promise. Having what? No hope. So it's so sad that people are now in Christ and still have no hope. It's wickedness. It's the wickedness of Satan. Yeah, you are in Christ. That was how you were when you were not in Christ. And then you are still in Christ and you have no hope. That is sad. So Christians here, you got to hear these things. It doesn't matter the church you go to or whatever. I don't care. It matters on your heart. You're one on one with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And as the person understanding comes, strength will come to follow. He says, having no hope and without God in the world. But now, I love saying that. Whenever I pray, I say, but now. Amen. Amen. But now, in Christ Jesus, even sometimes we are far off. Amen. Now, by the blood of Christ.
Making us one with him.
Amen.
He showed it prophetically as a type in the bringing in of Ephraim and Manasseh to come into the firstborn status. He said, Ephraim and Manasseh are mine, as Reuben and Simeon are mine. The firstborn, the birthright. There was an engrafting in of the Gentile church. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't worry. The understanding is the spirit. Praise God. That is it. He has brought us one. He has brought us into that is what is called the adoption. Bringing us that peace. Breaking that middle wall of partition. That we can access every right of blessings that is found in Israel. Amen. Praise the Lord. Having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances, to make in himself of twain, one new man, so making peace. These were two people, he took them and made them one. And that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain what? The enmity thereby. That he might reconcile us unto God in one body by the cross. The cross of Jesus is what reconciles us. Whatever sin you may have committed, the cross brings a reconciliation. And he makes peace, praise the name of the Lord. And he says, and came and preached peace to you, which were afar off. He did it 2,000 years ago. He came and preached peace to us. Wow. We were afar off. And to them that were nigh. He preached it to both. For through him, we both have access by one spirit unto the Father. Now, therefore, ye are no more strangers and foreigners. You are no more a stranger and a foreigner, but a fellow what? Citizen with the saints and of the household of God. This is more honorable. Think of the most honorable nation in the world. Is it America? The citizenship of the United States of America is rags compared to this. Because even the systems in America will be judged. The system, the evil systems of anywhere wickedness is found in the world will be judged and destroyed. Praise the name of the Lord. But this place, there is no destruction coming to it. We are asked the kingdom of David, the house of David, will grow stronger and stronger.
Amen.
It continues to expand and increase in strength and territory. It says, you are no more strangers. So even after today, if you accept Jesus Christ, and peradventure along the way, maybe you fall to a sin, you are not a stranger. As long as you have the blood of Jesus Christ, you can call unto him and continue to hold on unto him until you learn. By the help of the Spirit of God to stand in life and to stand in strength. So you are never a foreigner, you are no more a citizen. There is no revoking of citizenship except you willfully choose to revoke it. Pray by yourself. He said, now, okay, yes, and are built up upon the foundations of the apostles and the prophets as contained in scripture. You know, that built on the foundation, but Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone is the surest foundation in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto an holy temple of the Lord, in whom ye are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. So we see that all of us make up the house of God. And in the end of Ephesians, chapter 1, actually, that should be verse 22, and put all things under his feet and give him to be head over all things where in the church. So Jesus Christ is, you know, the head of the church. And that is a way, it's an anomaly, you know, that we also see where men have risen and raised themselves against God, over God's heritage. You know, and you have things like the pastor who is controlling the lives of everybody, and you just come and sit down. I tell you, brethren, in the house of God, as we see, you all make up the house of God, there is no vestigial organ in the house of God. And forget what the scientists are telling you, it is a lie. The appendix is not a vestigial organ. Then nobody tried to remove your appendix or anything. Don't give consent to that. It's not vestigial. They didn't make it. They cannot determine that it's vestigial. You know, praise God. There's some research actually out there. You know, if you check it, it says that belly has a use. It has a use. You know, it's not vestigial. But there is no vestigial part in the house of God. So you come and you just sit down every day, sit down, nothing, no use. You become useless, house of God, no contribution, no nothing. That is not the design. The design is Christ, the head of the church. Although there is an authority recognized by God
for people to oversee the house of God, but they don't lord over the heritage of God's house. Only God is lord over your life, and no man is lord over your life. That is what we need to understand. Those of us who are in people, a lot, like I said, 99% or so, a huge percentage of churches is that way. There is no say you come, the pastor is almost like God, is what the pastor says, you go. He says we have access by one spirit unto God. So you must be in the place where you are allowed to express and allowed to grow. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As you can see, there are things, this insatiable nature in man, you know, it causes all manner of the root of all manner of things and all manner of evil enterprises in the heart of man. And we're going to make two prayers. Number one cast of prayers is just short prayers, nothing long. Is for those, if you know that you do not have this relationship with Jesus. Either you tried to have it before, you know, but you fell out of the way due to challenges and whatever, you know, or you just have not come to receive this blood of Jesus Christ. You know, you pray, you know, where you are, you pray and you say, Lord Jesus, you know, I receive you into my life. You know, we have time to pray. Father, and then we will pray that Lord Jesus, I receive to receive the blood of Jesus Christ. Come and be Lord over my life. Grant me a new life. You know, change me. You know, grant me help to receive Jesus. You know, if you are here, please let us just begin to pray. Make that prayer. You say, Lord Jesus, I receive you into my heart. Put your hand on your chest and say, Lord Jesus, I receive you. I want to have a relationship with you. I want to have a life with you. I'm tired of the travails, of the striving, going on and on, you know, just weariness, tiredness, all manner of vices in the earth. I need a change. I need a transformation. Place your hand on your chest and say, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. First of all, say, Lord Jesus, please forgive every sin that I've committed. Forgive every sin. I do not lead anyone to a prayer because I actually, frankly, don't really believe in that. It's with your mouth you will confess it. Not people putting the words in your mouth. Say, Lord Jesus, I want to receive you. Make those prayers in that line. Forgive every sin that I've committed. And if you know the sin in your heart, communicate it to God. These things I do, I'm sorry, Lord. Forgive me. Forgive me my iniquities. For he has borne your sins. He has borne your iniquity. He bore it on the cross. Therefore, Satan can no longer afflict you for it. Receive the life of Jesus. Oh, the transforming power in the blood of Jesus. Say, Lord God, forgive me. And I receive your spirit. I receive your spirit in my heart. Pray and say, Lord God, I receive your spirit in my heart. I receive you in my life. Come and be my Lord. Come and be my master. I denounce every agreement that I have had with anything that is not of you. I come by your blood and I break it. I come by your blood and I destroy it. And I come into a covenant with you. I come into an agreement to serve you all the days of my life. Take my life and let it be. Own me, O Lord, from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. Possess me, O Holy Spirit. Let your life come into me and make me a new man, a new woman from this day. I want to be a partaker of the blessings in you. I don't want to miss out of the blessings in Christ Jesus. I want to partake of it. Oh God, help me. Help me. The scripture says that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Father, we bless you because there is much joy in heaven. For the sinners that come unto you, for people who do not have you that receive you. Father, look at all these, they are in your hands. And we know, as is your record, that not one of them will be lost.
Yeah.
That you will preserve them and keep them.
Yeah.
Oh God, you have seen them, you have heard the prayer of their hearts, because that is the most important thing. You have heard the prayer of their hearts. Oh, Holy Spirit, help them to confess these things that they have prayed. Help them to open their mouth and confess it. Grant them to preserve them in life. Strengthen them. Let the Spirit of God, let the living waters flow over all these souls. In the name of Jesus, we
on this soul. Satan, you have fallen like lightning from thy heaven, and the Son of righteousness has arisen with healing in his wings. Oh, let the Spirit of God break this one. In the name of Jesus, let them be that emperor of the Holy Spirit in their life. Oh, let them begin to come into experience divine encounters with the Lord. Encourage them, oh Lord. Encourage them much. For you have said that you shall feed your flock like a shepherd. You shall gather the lambs in your arms and carry them in your bosom. And you will gently lead those who are vulnerable. Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you for this one. We rejoice with them. We rejoice in them. We rejoice in this day of their coronation and their awarding as sons and citizens of the heavens. Oh, Father, we thank you because they have been accepted into the kingdom of heaven. Oh, Father, we bless you.
Bless.
For this one shall press on unto the redemption of the purchased possession.
Amen.
We shall come into life and glory. Father, we thank you for this one. In Jesus' name we pray. Briefly, the next prayer. You are a Christian. You have had a relationship with God. I don't care wherever you be, anywhere, any church or whatever. But you know that you have not been serious. You are an earth that has not been filled with water. You know you have not been serious with the Lord Jesus Christ. You have played with your Christian life up to this point. You have been unfaithful to God. Make that prayer briefly and say, Lord, I'm sorry. He said, Lord, from today I rely on your Spirit for strength. I first of all propose in my heart. It starts with the heart. Because David, the Lord appeared to David and said, David, seek my face. Psalm 37. And he says, David turned and says, David was narrating the experience where he says, the Lord said, he said, when thou said, seek me my face, my heart said, thy face, Lord, will I seek. So, come in your heart, say, Lord, your face will I seek. Help my heart, strengthen my heart, strengthen my will. He said, it is God that works in us to will and to do of his good pleasure. Say, Lord, I don't care how old I am, whatever, I've been a Christian, but I've not put you as my chief priority. Help me. I'm sorry for being unfaithful. For when I put you as my chief priority, then every other thing in my life will find a balance. Say, Lord, please help me. Grant me strength. I'm sorry, and I ask for your Spirit. I cannot do it on my own. I ask for your Spirit to help me to become serious with the things that pertain unto you. He says that you sent rain to confirm your inheritance when you were weary. And as the prodigal son, we know that your arms are always open to receive back the child that has gone astray. Even though you have spoken against them, but in Jeremiah 10, when you say, is Ephraim my dear son? Is he my dear child? You say, for ever since I spoke against him, my heart has been towards him. My bowels are torn for him. You say, will I not have mercy upon Ephraim?
Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, we thank you for your mercy, for the bowels of mercy towards us, your tender mercy. For thou hast said, mercy shall be built up forever, and thy faithfulness shall be established in all generations.
Amen.
We ask that these ones will be saved back in you. We ask for your Spirit to take hold of them, that they will walk in life, they will reign together, all of us shall press on to the highest in you. Our hope is beyond this world, as you have told us. Our hope is beyond this present time. Our hope is eternal, it's everlasting in you. We ask for strength to press on. We ask for strength to turn the battle back to the gates of the enemy. We will not fight at the walls of the enemy, lest we be casualty, but we will take the battle to the gates. We will turn it to the gates of the enemy. Father, we ask for help. We ask for, we receive all this one. We ask for your Spirit to breathe upon each and every one here, enduring us with strength and might. This city of Hamilton shall be taken for the Lord.
Amen.
Every form of wickedness, by reason of this statement that your church has made today, we take charge of the heavens of this place. And we say, every wicked spirit we command you to call in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We bind you that there shall be free course of the gospel in this land. This land shall be taken for the Lord Jesus Christ. This land shall be for Jesus. Father, you know all of your saints here, all of your prophets in this place. We ask, O Lord, that you meet with them in their personal point of need and help them. Grant them great help. Father, we thank you. We thank you for grace. Great grace. grace and abundant grace. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.